We're ready to go. It's 9 o'clock. Let's call this meeting order with a moment of silence. Thank you. First, we approve the agenda.
Move to approve.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to approve the agenda. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Any public comments?
No.
Nobody's moving. Let's approve minutes of July 2.
So move to approve.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to approve minutes of July 2. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Number 4, we have the Treasurer's Report, Sheriff's Quarter and Annual, Recorder's Quarter and Annual, and the Veterans Affairs Fourth Quarter.
Move to approve all 4.
Motion to approve all 4.
Second.
Supported by Steve. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. M-Card Report, Deanne will not be here. She's setting up for the fair. Dave Sedevec is not here. If he shows up, we'll give him 2 minutes. Okay. Consider denial of homestead application for fiscal year 19. Do you have a copy of that? I know one of them. I think one of them. You've got a copy of it. Mark got a copy of it. We have 2 that are denied by the board of, or the
assessor
has 2 of them that don't qualify for homestead credits that were applied for. And so.
I make a motion we deny them.
Supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. 6 south section. Now that must not be my, I thought that was my brother-in-law, but it's not. It's too far south. Okay. Mr. Bemis.
Morning, Troy.
Good morning.
Good morning. I got my quote back for the BHS roof, Mahaska building, to do another 30 foot of that. We did 30 foot probably 3 years ago. We put $5,000 into that capital improvement or whatever that is for the roof for that building. And that goes till 2026. And so it looks like to finish it off, we might need another year or two extended onto that at that point. But because it does get a little bit longer because of that canopy, so we're not going to get as much coverage for $15,000. But anyway, it's $15,258.87 to do approximately 30 more feet, and that'll get us past our next leak too. So we had one this spring when it really poured sideways, so it'd be the same. They'll just continue on with that Duralast roof, cap it off like they did this time.
You got a quote from
It's Hopkins.
Yeah.
They're the ones that did it.
They did the other. They did the first section. Okay.
I got the quote here. Do you have another sheet paper where they have a late beginning date or a finishing date on it? The reason I'm asking is, you know, we've had this with this car on the second truck point.
I don't think I do, but when they came last from, I mean, it took them a day, so I don't think it'll be an issue, but I can get that for
Jim
you.
Just wanted to make sure we start putting on the contracts.
Probably a good idea.
An ending date, so if they don't have the job done, there's no issue with the contract, whether it's still valid or not valid, but
yeah,
it'd be very absolute on the job.
Yeah, we can do that. We did that with these bigger ones, you know, they always have an end date.
Yeah.
Yeah. I see if you'll put that in there somewhere. Okay.
How do you want to do that? Just approve the bid?
I make a recommendation to approve the bid and have Troy get an ending date.
Okay.
On the contract.
Okay.
That was a motion.
Second.
Second by Steve. Motion made and seconded to approve the bid. $15,000 some odd dollars for the Mahaska building down on South 11th. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Next one?
Next ones are stonework on the courthouse again, had on there last time. And there's a couple of questions about it, and I called Justin. And he said the reason that he strips that all off is he doesn't know what's back there, you know. He wants to get down to sound limestone before he repaints it. He said that's the only way he bids of us. And so I don't know why we haven't ever had somebody else bid at that one, I guess, but...
Well, with the car bid, it was quite a little cheaper. They were just gonna power wash it and paint it again.
Yeah, and he said there's no way you'll get all that loose off there.
And I would be in favor of stripping it down and doing it right.
And I did ask him about how long he thought that would last, and he said he'd hope 5 to 10 years. I mean, he said 10 years is gonna be pushing it on paint outside like that, but he said I'd hope 5 at least, you know. So, and he couldn't come today. They're from Illinois, and they didn't have anybody in the area. But
if they strip it down and paint it, then the next time they probably just wouldn't have to do that. I wouldn't think, if everything's going well, if it looks good.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. You might be able to get by again maybe once, and then maybe strip it down every other time. Or
yeah, it's getting...
I don't really know.
It's getting pretty tacky in places.
Yeah.
So.
And everywhere you walk around, there's all kinds of... You can just push on, there's loose. And if you pull some off, it's all powdery and chipped back there, you know, so...
They do that this summer? Are they figuring on doing it?
They say they'll do it when they're doing the law center.
Okay.
At some point there, because they'll be in town. And then I talked to Jim on this car, Tuck Wayne. I think he talked to you guys to get out of it or whatever. So.
Yeah, he didn't think it would stand up.
He didn't think it would be, yeah. He said you guys should probably send them an email. I can get you that information. Instead of coming from me, he said you should probably do this.
Okay.
But I'll get your contact.
I'm wondering if we should, kind of same way, I think I'd like to approve this if we get an ending date.
Any date. Yeah, I think we can get that.
Want it done before winter. We don't want to go another year out front. That's been, it keeps rolling,
yeah,
off.
It just gets worse.
Yeah.
The water's getting in there.
I think I have to make a motion to rescind the offer for cars to the year and a half old. And the work's been done, and then accept the BSM offer with an ending date on it.
Okay.
So I'll make a motion to rescind contract from Carr and accept the BSM contract if we can get an ending date.
Okay.
For the contract.
And it's done this year.
We completed this year.
Yeah, they're coming mid-August to start the law center, so I don't know when they'll do it, but I'll get an ending date for it. So I don't... Let's just wait before you sign either one of those, and then I'll see if I can just include it on a contract.
That'd be good.
Instead of another page.
Right.
Okay.
So the motion is just to rescind the car tech plan?
You want those two,
yes.
Two motions?
Would be easier to merge. I'll make a motion. Scratch my last motion, if that's okay.
Nobody's approved it. We'll start over.
Make a motion to rescind the car contract from a year and a half ago.
Supported. Comments? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Now, new motion.
Make a motion to accept the BSM contract for the foundation of the courthouse, for the tuck pointing and the painting. Try to get an ending date for the contract to be completed this year.
I'll second that.
It's been seconded. You get the number from Troy. Number to put in there. I think you should put that in.
I don't have that.
You got it,
so
right?
I don't.
You should have it. All right. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. You're done. Thank you.
Aye. Thanks, Troy.
Thanks, Troy.
Okay, Dave Sadovic, I said you got 2 minutes since you're late.
Here's my report, see you later.
You got that roof finished yet? I shouldn't laugh, every time I come by there, I've got to come that way to town now. They got a little section there, and then they got that other section, and...
Well, I happen to have somebody that got me back into the last pallet of roof panels for the wall.
Oh, boy. All right. You can update us on that now.
Okay, now the official update. Yeah, the part about the building is that it's, the last part of the roof, is somebody backed into it, and now they have to make all new roof panels for the stuff that was destroyed. They finally have the main wiring into the building after, between, I know I'll be nice and say miscommunication, but after Mid-America, three different ways it's had to go into the building until they finally approved it. They turned all the heating air conditioning units on the other day, and I was shocked that within 2 hours the building was cool, even with just those plywood doors on and everything. There's been a few on-the-fly design changes, I'll put it that way, but seem to have most of those worked out. Things are starting to go a little better. The highlight of my last couple of weeks is Clay Birch from New Sharon is doing the landscape, the retaining wall block, and just, that looks great. That's, you know, that's my high point, is going out there and the retaining wall stuff's doing phenomenal. They're still talking at least a month out to get the elevator in. The interior stairs are in, but they're pans where they pour concrete on the steps, and the concrete isn't poured yet. The steel for the support for the decking, everything's supposed to come in this week. It's been really weird with this building. We've had a lot of problem getting the steel products in that, you know, I thought would have been months ago. I don't understand it, but I just get frustrated. But things are moving forward, and I didn't turn my ringer off. But, and it is what it is. We pushed our date back. Now, we're going to be probably into September before we're into the building, it looks like. Been working with the display company. I anticipate another phone call from them this week about what we're doing for displays as far as costs and priorities and things like that. So it's moving forward. It's on a two-phase project. The first phase, we're going to have to set back a little bit because they're supposed to put it in August. And I don't want to put a bunch of displays in while there's still construction work going on, because that's not good for anybody. But it's just, it's moving slowly, but it's, you know, it is what it is. Last year, our camping revenue, it was up a little bit more. We were up to a little over $42,000 for the year, which, you know, was up like almost 400% in 8 years from what it used to be. The new restrooms and the new side help put the new side in. An issue we have now with the Eagle being so popular is that when the electricity was put in, it wasn't put in anticipating, you know, the size of campers and stuff. So we've got a couple electricians looking at stuff, not getting bids yet, but getting quotes, because we're probably going to have to rewire the campground to handle bigger campers and stuff that we get.
Is that on both sides of Evelyn or just one side?
It's eventually going to be both sides. The old side's worse. When the new side was put in, really the wires, probably one gauge lighter than what it should have been. But for right now, we're getting by on that side, but the old side in particular is really light for the traffic that we get. And didn't have great, the 4th of July is usually one of our busiest weekends, but being on a Wednesday, and it's been my experience throughout my career, if you have a 4th of July and a Wednesday, it kind of splits it up between two weekends, so you don't have either weekends really big, but both weekends were busy. And so, I mean, we're, things are plugging along there. We've got our new vault toilets, pit latrines are coming in next month. We're replacing the one at Nicholson, and both of them are white oak. And so that means, last couple of years, all of our vault toilets in the county that were in disrepair are, they're all going to be replaced. So that they'll smell better, they'll be, you know, better for the people, and they'll be environmentally better too, because they're not leaking. And then, as far as environmental ed, the Flores summer camps finished up last week and had really good turnout for those. Now we're getting ready to have a meeting tonight for planning our youth outdoor field day in September. And one thing that the DNR and ourselves and Pheasants Forever are partnering on, we're going to do a metric youth dove hunt this year at our food plots out in Cedar Bluffs. And dove season always starts on September 1st, which happens to be a Saturday this year. So the morning of September 1st, we're going to have Cedar Bluffs shut down and just the kids and our youth mentored hunt and give them, we want kids that have never been hunting before to go out and try to experience hunting. And then we'll open it back up to the public at noon. And then we have all our other, of course, areas with dove food plots will be open, you know, to the public that day. But hopefully that'll turn out good. It's the first time we've tried it, so we'll see what happens. And other than that, just mowing, trimming, working on picnic tables, you know, summertime stuff.
Okay. I have no questions.
Thanks, Dave.
I haven't heard anything. I haven't heard anything, so it must be going good.
Okay, that's good. No news is good news, right?
That's right.
Yeah. Thank you.
Dave Shanahan.
Board of Health first.
Oh, Board of Health. Wait a minute. I skipped one. Can't skip one, Dave. Hang on a minute. This might take more than 2 minutes, but I'm not sure. We have a request from the Board of Health to raise the sanitarian salary after we've already approved budgets from $46,459 to $51,000. How's that work, Jody?
Isn't that they're his board? So.
They're his board. I think that's a pretty good jump, but we're kind of there. I could voice my objection, but I don't think so. Too far. We just approve their actions. We like those kind of boards. They take care of the workforce, don't they, Mark? All right.
Excuse me.
We're kind of stuck with it. Make a motion to approve it. Make a motion to approve the Board of Health's recommendation.
Support.
Any further discussion? Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Now we can go, Dave.
Good morning, Dave.
First off, I have two contracts that need to be signed by the board for the VR for the Kent Avenue Bridge. It's VR 62, Para 92, AKA 62.
That is down north of Given, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay. Placement of a bumps culvert, Liable Bridge. Contract for $205,760.50. Need a motion to approve this contract.
Make a motion to approve and the chairman to sign, authorize signature for the Kent Avenue Bridge.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to approve the contract. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. I am the contracting authority, correct?
Yes.
Local contract.
801, I saw it online. Line 16. Okay. Pass it back. You can get a copy, you don't get a copy. At some point, you get a copy, don't you?
The next item, we've got two trucks, the truck that we pull belly dump trailers with, number 51 and number 21. Both of them have a fair amount of engine problems right now. The cab on 51 is basically rusted out where we've got the back window glued in with Bondo. And the cab is rusted out on 21. Instead of, to stay within the budget that we have, we searched around for a while and found two used trucks from Mack that are a 14 and a 15 model that with our trade stuff would stay within the money that we had budgeted for equipment. And I would recommend that we would do this because those tractors are a 91 and a 97. They both have a lot of miles on them. The front ends are bad. You know, we've spent money over the last few years trying to keep them up, but they're starting to just be down all the time. And instead of hauling rock with belly dumps, we're hauling rock with small trucks, spending more money doing less good with it. And we use them in the wintertime as well, too, to bring rock into the yards.
How much money?
The 2015, they went 72.5, and the 2014, they went 66.5. We're trying to negotiate a deal with the trade of our two trucks to get it at about 120, 125,000. Which would be what we would pay for one new truck if we were ordering it straight out.
How many miles we got on them?
191,000 and 202. They're both day cab tractors. Both trucks have wet kits on them, so they can be used for the low boy and the side dumps. They're not just a straight truck tractor. Test drove the 2015 and it works very well. Power wise, it's an improvement on what we have. They both have the exhaust fluid technology in them, so it's not just straight EGR technology. Is black and the 14 is white. They painted the 15, which was white, black so that they would have diverse colors in their fleet. Some people don't like just a white truck, some people like different colors. The 15 has all new tires on it. The 14, we were going to swap the tires off of our truck, which are all new, onto that one.
They have the same motors in them?
No, the old trucks have an MP7, which is about 350 horsepower tractor. These are 445 at an MP8. And they have the automatic, so it's easier for people that aren't, if they're not used to driving a manual transmission, they can get into that and drive it easier. They have the manual option on there for spreading if you want to keep it in one gear and stay in one gear when you do that.
But both the 14 and 15 have the same engine, the same setup.
Are identical except a year difference. And we had, on 51, we're just, it's always in the shop, and 21's in there too, and we just fixed it not long ago, and it's doing the same thing, so there's evidently something more major in the motor and some other stuff. We could throw 10, 15,000 at both of those trucks right now and still have 600, 700,000 mile trucks.
Well, what's your pleasure?
How many miles a year do they drive, or how many days a week do they use these trucks?
In the spring and fall, quite a bit. Over the winter, we use them to shuttle rock into the yard when we save on hauling and stuff. They also, we use it to haul sand in for our sand mixture when we're hauling for our salt and sand. So we use them quite a bit. And it's a lot more economical hauling with a 24-ton load than it is with an 8-ton load, because you're having the same amount of fuel burn, basically, and the same number of hours to haul one-third of the material. So it saves all the way down the line.
Budget for new purchases after this. How much will this leave in the budget?
We'll have enough to buy the truck that we have already ordered, and we didn't have to buy a pickup, so that's already taken care of. We got the little, or the other belly dump taken care of, so the only thing that would change would be if we were buying an excavator with a cutter head. But in looking at it, we haven't been able to come up with anything we really feel that comfortable with, so we're going to rent. We have money in the clearing budget to rent and try different cutters on there to see which, A, throws the least amount, where we can control where it goes, and whether a wheel or a track type works better. We have a way of doing that by just renting them for a week or a month. And that's what we're going to do, so that when we do buy it, we know exactly what we are getting, and we won't be surprised by it.
Ben likes that idea.
Yeah, I think this way, you know, there's still the talk about rubber tires versus that. I talked to Keokuk County, they like their rubber tire, but they're limited into where they can go. And the track machine, you gotta have a low boy, so there's drawbacks to both. And I just haven't found anything that we can get for what we had put aside for, plus what Ben had. You're doing that, you're getting a $6,000-$8,000 machine. If you buy a machine like CAT or someone local where you know you're going to get your parts and your cutter, you go to Beacon, you go to Dennis CMAP, which are the two leading ones on that. Or even a skid steer with one on it too. I mean, there's a lot of places you can cut with a skid steer and get to it. Where we had the deep fills and stuff, you got to have something that you can get over and reach it, or get down and reach it from the bottom. And that's where the track machine would shine. But on a lot of the ground where you can drive it there, where you don't have a deep fill or a deep cut area, then your rubber tire would work fine because you can get out far enough. And you don't have the lifting or the side balance on a wheel-tired excavator that you do on a track. They just, you know, you're putting all your weight on those two little pads that are out there.
Well, I see a lot of places like an Argyle Road where an hour with a skid loader would fix a lot of problems. Mm-hmm. So it'd be nice to have a versatile machine that'll do both. Because, you know, to move a tractor takes a lot of hours of manpower just to move it in and out.
Yeah.
So.
And I'm not real a big fan of producing them because you can't find parts for them a lot. They're not a local brand, and CAT's still looking for one. They're looking for a 180 size instead of the 200 size. It's a little bit smaller, doesn't cost as much, easier to move around, it's roadable and stuff, and I think that's where we'd be better served on that, if we go with that, and then just see what we can cut with it, and if we need to do something different, that's what you would do.
I think it's a good idea to rent one for a while, see how it works.
You'll know if you need to get one that's got the auxiliary power pack, where you're not heating up the hydraulic oil of your excavator. You can burn up an excavator like that, because that's a lot of load on that system, and you're pulling a lot of gallon per minute. And so just putting it on any machine is not a wise thing to do.
Okay, back to the trucks.
If we buy these two trucks, that'll pretty much use up your budget till when?
Well, that'll take care of that, and the other truck that we're buying, that'll probably use up. And we got the tractor with the side boom, so those are all that would be taken care of. And we have the tractor with the side boom. We're working out a deal with them because it had a cut inside of the rear tire, and I want to make sure that that's taken care of before we do too much with it.
We're all sitting here. I don't have a problem with the used trucks, that they're probably basically been highway miles, I would assume.
They're all highway miles.
That makes a big difference. You run them on a gravel road, and those old Macs got to be getting tired.
They are, in the frames and the front ends and the trunnions in the back. I mean, you could start.
One's 26 years old, 27. We got the goodie out of it.
And the one has blow by or pressure in the engine, so we know that there's probably either a liner, a block, or a sleeve or something cracked in it, where it's building back pressure. And the other one's just got blow by, and both cabs leak a lot of dust, so when they're out running them, they just fill up with dust. And it's hard on the guys, too.
I'll make a motion to approve the purchase of two used trucks to replace units number 21 and 51.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to approve the purchase of these two trucks we've been talking about. You can fill in the details.
Will you stop down in the office and have Veronica make copies of what you have of the contract?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Thank you, Dave.
You're welcome. And just for an update on 65, they're about up to 200. They're starting from the north end to remove concrete, but they're putting rock. I think that's all the way down to the water treatment plant for rural water. So we're getting some movement now, and we've fixed some of the saw spots, and we're running along.
All right.
Thanks, Dave.
Thanks, Dave.
13, closed session for Iowa Code 215C.
Make a motion to go to closed session.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to go into closed session for Iowa Code 21.5-C. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Okay. I need a motion to go back into open session.
So move.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to go back into open session. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. We are back in open session. We had a phone call with an attorney to discuss possible appeal of the judge's ruling on the 2080 agreement with Penn and Mahaska. I don't know where we start, what you want to say. For my part, you know where I stand. I think the judge is very clear on this thing. The agreement's valid. We can continue to spend money, spend more money, and cause the city to spend more money, and in the end, we don't know what we're going to gain. And if somebody else wants to take up the suit, that's fine, but I think as a county, we should be done. And that's just my opinion, or my feelings on it. It's just not opinion.
Initially, we had some questions on the 28D that I don't think got answered in the original court ruling. I think they should be answered, but I'm not sure. I don't know where you're at, Steve, but I guess I'd like to think a little bit what we talked about this morning. The attorney we talked with is fairly confident with the Supreme Court and had some court cases to for his argument, but I guess I'd like to have a few days to sit and digest it and give it some thought.
I would agree to that. It is a hot button issue in Mahaska County, and I think we need to look down all avenues before we decide what to do next.
So, I'm not going to take any action today. I don't know if you are. I'm not going to make any motions.
We got what, till the end of the month to decide, basically?
It has to be filed by the, I understand, the 29th. That's a Sunday. We should meet later in the week, I would think, if you're going to give this attorney time to, if you want to appeal, you're going to have to give him a few days to get his stuff in order.
Yeah.
So, you better set a, I think we ought to set a date to meet.
I think maybe the 25th. Yeah, he said not the 26th. He said not the 28th.
Yeah. Well, it's up to you if that's when you want to meet.
I'm not sure we have to meet yet. I'm just saying I'm not ready to take any action today.
Okay. Then we can set that later if you decide you want to meet. Okay. Action taken. Committee reports. I met with the animal shelter people on the 2080 agreement. They're going to kind of redo it. The one that was drafted by Dave Dixon in 14, we're going to make some changes in that, and they will come to a meeting in August and we'll discuss it. So, we'll redo the 2080 agreement with the city and the county and the Humane Society. I don't know which date in August, but one of the meetings they're going to come back up. We're going to talk about it.
And that one's outdated. Never agreed with
you. Well, yeah, things have changed.
Yeah.
And, so that's that.
I know an agency on agent where Milestones dropped off any funding.
They dropped all the funding?
So that's $1,000 a month to our local area.
Do you get, they still do the food though? Mm-hmm. And they pay the cooks and the bread?
Yes.
Okay.
But there's no meal attendant or anything like that any longer.
That's too bad.
So they are applying to Wapello County that way to see if they can help. So we provide all the meals to Wapello County.
See if they can kick in some money.
See if they'll help.
The supervisors, they're going to talk to
I'm going to talk to, I've got DCAP meeting this afternoon.
Okay.
I'm going to talk to Brian, see if they'll be looking at it. So.
All right. We didn't put on here was committee assignments. We'll do that. We'll do that next month. I guess we
said that last time. Too.
Yeah, we said that last time.
I just assume these don't take over Dolan.
Yeah. Okay. We'll see what they are. All right. I don't have anything else. Anybody public?
We do adjourn.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.